From Monday to Friday, thousands of school children rely on the train to get them to school. But this week, many of them have been spared that last-minute rush to catch it because, thanks to the rail strike, there have been a few days recently when there have been no trains running at all. Well, almost no trains.
This is the Romney, Hythe and Dymchurch miniature steam railway deep in the wilds of Kent, and because it's not part of British Rail, it's the only railway in the country to keep its trains running every day, despite the nationwide strike. And these are its most regular and often reluctant passengers. They use it 5 days a week to get to and from school.
If I didn't have the train to go to school, I'd have to walk or bike to school. Or my mum wouldn't be able to, my mum or dad wouldn't be able to afford to keep running back and forth in the car because the petrol's expensive.
The old ladies, when you go past their house, they start waving their frying pans about and their tea cloths.
One of the big problems, the things I don't like about travelling on the train is prefects, when you stick your heads out, they shout at you to get them back in again.
And it's probably a good job they do, otherwise you could end up with a severe headache. These trains have been running without a break since the railway opened in 1927, and in the 5 years the school train's been going, it's only been late twice.
The first time I ever came on the train, there was it was quite hard trying to get a carriage, but I eventually did. And when I got in the carriage, after about a week, they put reserve sign on it, so I had to go in somewhere else.
The train's called Dr. Sin after a famous local smuggler.
You can see all the views, and it's nice in the summer. People like travelling on it, and you can see all the sheep and flowers in the summer and spring. One bad thing about it is when people try to do their homework, the train jogs, and one person tried to do their homework and it flew out the window of the carriage. The people who travel on the train are some of the luckiest people in Kent because hardly anybody travels to school on trains.
Well, not by the world's smallest public railway anyway. And so it finally pulls into New Romney, 5 miles from its first pick-up point. This is where the 250 passengers pile out onto the platform, trying hard not to think of the delights that lie ahead. However, having a journey like this every day must help, and this lot get it absolutely free.
Well, travelling by miniature steam train has got to be one of the most unusual ways of getting to school each day. It's certainly the strangest way we know of. But you may know better. If so, write to us at CBTV and you too could be reporting on how you make the journey to and from school.